have our design all set up, it's time to work through the rest of the store and get our products in there. As you can see, I've added a couple of things in here, different product categories as well. So let's walk through how to do that now. If you aren't already, come on over to the sidebar and scroll all the way down to the shopping cart, the tag that says e-commerce. We're going to be walking through products, categories, and discounts. Because I'm working off a template, a lot of this is already set up for me, but let's take a look at what we can change. Just like any other collection list in Webflow, if you click on the little gear icon, it will allow you to go into the settings for that particular collection list. As you can see, there are quite a few things already set up for me in this particular template. So the heavy lifting is done, but go ahead and take a look at the different categories to see if there's something you would like to adjust. As you can see, each product type does have different available fields. So if you're selling digital products, you can delete out perhaps information on inventory. As you can see, the shipping information is not there because there won't be anything to ship. And you can keep coming through the different services. So go ahead and take some time if you're working through a template to delete out the fields that are not relevant for you. And depending on which category you are using, this may take a little bit longer. If you're only using one category, the digital, for example, or service, you wouldn't really need to set up the other fields at all. Once you have this all as you want it, go ahead and hit Save Collection. And then you can add in some products. Now, if this is full of 10 or 12 products, if you're using a template, you can go ahead and delete those out and then start adding in what you want. So as you can see, for demonstration purposes, I put in a physical, digital, and service. Again, that may not be relevant depending on what you're using your store for, but let's go ahead and take a look at the digital product so you can see how I've set that up. So as you can see, this is an immediate download available after checkout, audio files, ebooks, all those kinds of things. Want to be sure that you pick the digital product type and fill in the applicable information. If you don't have your categories set up, you can go ahead and add that here if you're using this template. If you're not and you don't need this, don't worry about it. Main image, more images, price, and again, tax. You'll need to check with your local tax codes. SKUs not relevant, inventory is not relevant. Come down here to the download section. You just want to give it a file name. Be sure that you're naming this appropriately. I suggest naming it something similar to what the individual is purchasing, if not exactly the same, so that they are aware of what they're getting. And then be sure you put in the correct URL to download the file. This will link to quite a few things, so you're going to want to double check that numerous times. From there, fill out any additional information you have added to your template and go ahead and hit save. You would repeat that process for any of the remaining items that you want to put in. I've added a few just for our demonstration purposes here. Next, you'd want to set up your categories. Again, since we're working with a template, we'll click the little gear icon and take a look at what is already in there. I haven't adjusted any of this, but as before, you would want to make sure that you're going through and putting in the appropriate custom fields, deleting anything out if you're using a template that isn't applicable to you. Once you have all of this updated, you can go ahead and hit Save Collection and either delete out all of the information that's here or go ahead and adjust them. So for this demonstration, I've gone ahead and added in a little ebook tag. You could also call this a digital product, digital download, whatever makes most sense for you. Linked it to the appropriate product so it displays correctly on my template, and gone ahead and just added in some basic information here. You'd want to do this again for each category of items that you're selling. So if you're only selling one thing, this could be a rather small list. Once you have all that done, just go ahead and close out. And the final thing we're going to look at is discounts. Now, as you can see, this doesn't have any kind of adjustment available. This is all just standard setup. So go ahead and hit add new discount and fill out the relevant information. As you can see, it can generate a code for you, which is pretty handy, or you can type in your own. You'll want to be sure that you're looking and paying close attention to the type of discount, whether or not it's a percentage, fixed amount, or just free shipping. You can set the dates for it to run on, or perhaps it never expires. And you can also set specific restrictions, so that's only applying to what you need it to. Once you have everything in as you want it, go ahead and hit create, and then you're ready to go. And that is setting up products, categories, and discounts.